hey guys, what's going on here? AMZ Lab sent me these headphones here, the Protokite Kite ANC918 to review. Those are active noise cancelling headphones. They have a very Bose QC35 look to them. The ear pads are very similar to Bose. And the look and size also. Although they are quite lighter, they still inspire some confidence in terms of build quality, such as the swiveling ear cups here attached with those four screws, which make things easier to service. The ear caps are really, really nice. Left and right, these inner markings are very similar to Bose as well. The size is also similar and they feel good. The lightness on the head is a absolute positive because for longer sessions, you will not feel them on your head. They have active noise canceling, which you can switch on and off. They also have a cable input, so you can do this without Bluetooth, which gives a slightly better quality as usual. Connection is without a problem and very quick to my Android phone, but also to my iPad. That worked very well. You have a USB micro charging. I would have preferred a USB-C here, but that is fine. They connect very easily to Bluetooth. That is always a thing that some headphones just don't connect very well. And they just look sharp. Here on my pro audio equipment, I'm a big headphone guy. They definitely don't look like inexpensive headphones as they are. They are at a fraction of the price than what Bose cost, and you can probably see the link in my comment section. I listened to a bunch of tracks and they all came out good. A slightly warm bass response, not all the way down to the lower low basses, so don't expect a huge thump, but a pleasant slight bass lift and maybe a nice roll off in the highs. So nothing too shrill, something pleasant, something that you could listen to for quite a long time. And I think that is what they are intended to be. They are supposed to be comfortable headphones that you can wear for a long time, that are light for the office or train rides, working and so forth, and without being clamping down too much on your head, wearing too much, and also not to fatigue your ear. Sound wise, I would say they are quite nice. Of course, they are not the equivalent of Bose QC35. Noise canceling has a switch. You can turn it on and off very easily. You don't need an app or you don't need a software to do that. That is also very nice. I would say it is a light setting. If you compare it to the Q35s, they have an app where you have three different settings, and I would say this is a light noise canceling feature. It is active, but it's not so that you're completely isolated from the outside world. So if somebody, you were at your office and you'd be listening with them, somebody mentions your name or talks to you, you could still hear them. So I think that is good. The only downside would probably be on plane rides where you want to drown out speaking and loud engine noises. I would say for that you would really need to go with more expensive headphones. And especially, like I mentioned earlier, the multi-angle rotation, just like with the Bose, makes it very easy to stow them away in the included case. Now, the case is included, that is nice. The manufacturer mentions also a play time of 50 hours. I haven't quite tested it yet, but I've had the phone for a couple of weeks now and I'm still on the first charge. So I have not listened to it all the time, but I've listened to it on and off. And for me, that's always impressive if a device can hold a charge for such a long time. So I think the battery is one of the big pluses here. All right. Thanks for checking out this video. Please like and subscribe.